All right, guys, we're playing the Chubby Buddy Challenge.
Chubby Buddy.
I mean, we know Michelle's gonna win. I mean, Nicole has so much room.
Four.
Yeah.
Chubby Bunny.
All that room in your mouth.
Chubby Bunny. Chubby Bunny.
Hello.
So we filmed this obviously in the last 3 days, but
we filmed this before Heath left.
Yeah, we couldn't talk about it.
I haven't left yet.
He's gone now.
I'm gone.
He's gone now.
I'm gonna sit here now.
We couldn't talk about it because Heath wanted to surprise his mom going home, and I can't post that one Monday.
Yeah, she watches his vlog, so
immediately
she would know, and it would ruin the surprise.
Anything that goes up, she's a boom, Heath.
she's notification squad.
No, like, oh, we're such thoughtful people. We think about that.
You fuck me over as soon as you leave. Dad, I need content.
But how long is the surprise?
I don't know yet. I bought a one-way ticket.
You're so crazy.
That's so crazy.
Sometimes. He's like, you know what? I'm going to buy a one-way.
Oh, Todd,
oh shit. I just woke up.
We didn't want to sit by your door and be loud, so we came a couple feet over.
Hey, we're over here. We're good.
So, guys, this is coming to an end, boys.
Yeah, I got to leave in like 2 hours and head out.
And I'm moving out. Tuesday.
I'm moving back to Huntington.
Boys, the wrap. The boys are breaking up, and that's a wrap. This is the Exposed channel, baby. Exposed, we expose all companies on this
and
channel.
Right now, we are exposing Spirit Airlines.
Spain, do you remember when we got to the airport on time?
God, yeah, hold on.
Spirit's here to interrupt us.
All right.
That was as soon as you turn on your camera.
Exactly, Spirit right? Airlines. First time Heath and I visited LA, we flew Spirit because it was like the cheapest airline. And you have to pay for goddamn everything.
You buy your ticket, but, and then they make you buy your seat on the plane.
I have. We flew out here, and we were getting ready to go home. We got there on time, and I go to like check in. And they're like, we canceled your flight. And I'm like, what do you mean? Like, they're like, we canceled your ticket. They were like, you didn't get on the plane to come here.
We both bought tickets together for this flight. We bought them together. It was on the same car. And we both got there. And they took my ticket. And they wouldn't take his ticket.
They were saying that I didn't fly here. They were like, we have it showing that you didn't get onto your flight to come to LA. And I'm like, I'm fucking here.
But I got on the plane. He didn't. And we
both
sat next to
each other. This is my boarding pass. It's stamped. They drew on it. But in the system, for some reason, it showed that I didn't get on. So they canceled my flight back.
That's some shit that would happen to Scotty.
So then we missed the flight home, had to stay another day, and then I had to buy a whole new fucking ticket and they wouldn't reimburse me.
That's unbelievable.
Fuck Spirit.
Fuck Spirit.
The flight a while back that I actually missed, they kept on delaying my flight. Remember that?
Oh.
They kept delaying my flight, and then I walked back like a minute after they said, okay, the flight's finally ready to board. Like, I didn't hear it right away.
Yeah.
And they weren't sending out updates, and I went over to get on the flight, and they were like, sorry, you missed it. The plane's gonna take off in 10 minutes. Like, I was like, what do you mean? It's not gone. Like, get on
what
the
mean?
Plane.
Sorry, you missed your flight.
It's right there. But like, you have to pay for your water on Spirit.
You have to pay for a seatbelt.
You have to pay for the oxygen tank.
The plane's going down. It's like, all right, guys, just go ahead and please swipe your credit card.
Oh God, we have such an influence. No one's gonna fly Spirit after this video.
They're gonna remember hearing about Spirit.
Everyone's gonna comment on, you didn't think we knew that already? Okay.
I bet you in 1 week after people watch this video, they'll forget that we talked about Spirit. They'll go on and see the cheapest flight and be like, oh, Spirit. I remember Zane and Heath were talking about Spirit. That sounds good.
You need a lot of Spirit to fly that bitch.
You know, like the CEO of Spirit's online, like, what the fuck's going on? Our stock's dropping, guys. What's going on?
Daddy Heath doesn't fly Spirit anymore. Pilots that watch this, I'm not flying Spirit anymore.
The pilots get charged to fly the plane.
Guys, just letting everybody know, this is my little sister. She really just wants to be a star in the vlogs now. Why don't you tell everybody what's your name? Hidayah. Oh, shit. I just said it. Hidayah, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself? If people want to know who you are, what do you like to do? Why do you have a scarf around your head?
Because it's my religion.
So she does it because it's your religion? Because you believe in it?
I believe in it. I believe that women should be treated on what's in our head, not what's...
Okay, let's not make this deep.
Well, when you learn to hold your camera straight and not shake it.
Bubba, come here. Guys, everybody, that's my dad. He looks 10 times better than I'll ever look in my entire life. But I gotta introduce the brother. Just in case anybody forgets his name is Ollie.
Oh, that's your shirt. Oh,
and he's a professional bowler. But her, not so hot. I think that scarf's a little too tight. We're just a bunch of Arabs that make fun of each other for being Arab, and that's fine. Doing great. You see, what you gotta do is you have to just align yourself.
Let me take a video of you.
She's such a sore loser.
I'm gonna show you how to bowl.
Got her ball, honey. Show me how to bowl.
Bubba, don't break your back out there.
Hey, your form was great, though.
Hey, Bubba, here.
You white boy.
My dad's side of my family are actually a bunch of comedians. They're the funniest people I know. Baby!
I'm gonna say something positive for Hidayah.
Hidayah, you're doing great. Just like whatever you're doing, just don't do that. That's great. Well, let's hope that we don't have to bring the stretcher out.
There it is.
Yeah! Positive family vibes all around. We got it. Jealous?
No! Bubba gives him bad advice to make him
Bubba,
feel.
Yeah.
He said bismillah and this guy ducked.
Yeah, say bismillah, Bubba.
Okay.
All right, don't say it too loud though. We don't know how other people will react. Trump stomps through the door.
You go, Zane. I am a child of the Lord. I do not curse.
Baba, break it back.
It's break a leg.
Now with Baba's history.
Airline lady.
Please, Mr. Rodriguez, meet your party upper level by United Airlines. Curve sign.
What? What's curve sign?
Curve sign.
People want to see something that can kill people, you know?
They want
something juicy.
Oi, oi.
Try to run in the bush.
Oh, there it is. Almost looks like the rat in our house. Yeah!
Hey, we got an armadillo. I feel like it's gonna bite me. We're not gonna eat it. Can only eat turkey today. You wanna feel him?
Kind of. Pet. I'm scared though.
Yes, we could teach you acro yoga, but I've always seen you as more of a circus character.
Circus character.
Ooh, that's offensive. Yeah.
What is acro yoga?
A combination of acrobatics and yoga. It's a two-person yoga routine in which you have a flyer and a base.
Okay, that I still don't know what that is. A flyer and a base.
You do cool stuff on top of each other.
That's what a lot of newlyweds like to do. That
so. Came out weird.
Let us show you.
Wow. Oh, whoa. This is the money shot. Spa music on it.
All right, let's do this.
Yo, we got this, right?
Yo,
me and you, baby. We got it.
Am I the base or am I the...
Okay, you really want the base with the strongest core. Right, and chest up.
No. What? One, two, three.
Your core tight. Up. Point your toes. Chest up. Finding your inner chi. You really want to focus on the... You just want to think light. Ooh, calm, like you're floating on water. Peaceful, tranquility. You're a little bit more like a stiff cat than a flowing bird. Peace, tranquility. Obtain the balance within you.
As you mount your base, really want to find your inner chi and connection through your partner.
Three, jump, skid.
Balance in your core.
Elegance! Elegance! Do the turkey.
After deeply connecting your soul with your heart, you want to search the universe, your inner purple vibration. Up.
Into handstand. Come. Working your body.
Come on.
Find the inner peace! As you close out your journey, you're going to find where your road ends. To the sky. One with the clouds. Wrap around. Doesn't it feel like you're floating on clouds?
Let's not get a hold of ourselves. We're gonna have a singing competition.
Ahead of ourselves.
You can't hold
yourself either. Okay, exactly. Yeah. All right, you get to pick the song that we are going to sing to. It's gonna be karaoke, and you have to get all the words right.
Well, I have this movie. It's kind of my fan music, and it's called Let It Go.
Let it go.
Oh, okay. You got this.
Or I'll start. Let it go.
No,
okay.
Different one.
Okay, go.
I literally don't know that song. That's not even fair.
It's gonna have to be Frozen.
It's gonna have to be Frozen. You
know. That's good. Yeah, if you know that song. My videos are gonna get copyrighted for singing that song.
Hello.
God, Charles.
She's
quiet, everybody.
She's quiet. You can't hang the whole song. You can sing the whole song, then let it go. Let it go. I ain't never back anymore. Let it go. But you couldn't get that for sure. On my knees, begging, please, give me that. I win.
Let the story jump. I see Lily the other night. She goes,
no. All right. Contest is over. All right, guys. So I wanted to talk a little bit about the campsite that you guys just saw just now. We basically go there every year for Thanksgiving. 15 to 20 of us, we all go there and we just spend like, I think 5 days there. And every year we run into either 1 to 3 bears. They'll pop out and we just got to scare them. We just got to scream at them. They'll run off. And then there's times where there will be a couple bears or three and they'll surround us. And we can't do anything about it. So we have to like call the park rangers and they have to come do whatever they have to do to scare the bears. bears off, and then we basically get kicked out for the rest of the time that we were supposed to be there. We would have to go to another campsite. But this year we ran into one bear. It was like a medium-sized bear, and it would come every night, and all we would have to do is we would scare it off, and then like 10 minutes later it'll like pop out somewhere else. If you do follow me on Snapchat, you probably saw it already, but we were trying to scare off the bear in the Snapchat, and you could see the bear if you look closely. So make sure to follow me on Snapchat if you haven't seen that yet. So me and my brother, we ended up leaving a day earlier because we didn't want to hit traffic, and you know, a lot of the family was gone, so we like decided to leave early. So Monday morning, my mom and my stepdad, they wake up in their tent and they saw the bear claw their tent out. Here are the pictures on the side here. It's just pretty crazy how the bear got that close to even to start clawing the tent. And I'm sure one of them like scared off in the middle of the night, but that's pretty crazy. But all right guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to like this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more stuff from me and all my friends and family now. So you know, usually I'd end the video with like, you know, working off of somebody and we do something cheesy and then the video ends, but I have nothing right now. So I'm going to do my best to slowly creep this song that I'm going to use right now and then end it. Daydream, I fell asleep beneath the flowers for a couple of hours on a beautiful day. Alright, so apparently armadillos carry leprosy, and now Charles has leprosy. How's that feel? Do you feel any different?
I feel like I'm tired of starting to turn into a zombie.
Where's Mother Teresa when you need her?